You don't know how to get comfort. There's no security around you. Perhaps a gender dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. So the light of every shadow of the Almighty. Some light to man as well. If you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you are light of every shadow of the Almighty. And even Ezra says, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. I call in Him and trust. Bible says, when a man's ways pleases the Lord, he makes his enemies to be at peace with him. He didn't call them your enemies. He didn't say your enemies are going to become friends. He said they are still your enemies, but they are compelled to be at peace with you. No matter what happens on your way, when they come around you and they come to fight you, they will be turned as stepping stone to your success. Joseph told his brothers, he said, you meant it for that. When you sold me, you thought I would be lost. When you sold me, you thought my destiny would be rubbished. You thought you took my coat of many colors, but you couldn't take my dream. You couldn't take the vision. You couldn't take the advantage of all my life. They might have tapped on it one thing or the other, but listen very well. God is granting you protection. He's granting you protection beyond your expectation. If you dwell in the secret place, what is the secret place of the Most High? Is that the dimension where you have to worship the presence of God personally? That environment that is filled with the instructions of the Most High God. That place that is filled with the understandings and the intimacy with the Creator. And the Creator. They tried to mess with a man who was walking in the secret place of the Most High. Some friends came and they said, oh, we're not going to spy against that. Let's go. This man thinks he's so intelligent. This man thinks he's an adapter. We're going to drink him against this God. Because we've tried him everywhere. We can't find anything good against this man. That's when they went to the king and said, oh, king, let us not serve any other God in this whole nation except the good king. And the king is bright.
Thank you.
said, bring down a lot of apples. And the God came from there. And the king asked, he said, who are those that conspired against the hill? They said, look at them here. And the king said, pack them, pack their families, pack their baggages, pack all that was with them, and threw them into the lion's den. The scripture said, before they got to the last part of the lion had finished them up. I don't know what I'm speaking to here. Those who will stand against your life in this year 2021 to tamper with your destiny, in the power in the name of the Lord will take victims on your behalf. Say, God is taking victims on your behalf. You don't think that you can dig a piece and fall into it. If you dig a piece for a child of God, if you come to plant this against one that is ordained by God, God will arise and fight for you. I say, the righteous things for the Lord to trouble them that trouble you. The righteous things for the Lord to trouble them that troubled you. Today, God is troubling your troubles. He's troubling your troubles. He's giving you peace in the midst of the storm. The disciples were with Jesus in the storm. And Jesus was sleeping in the storm. And the disciples were surprised. How could this man, the man, wake him up? Okay, we are sleeping, and we are about to perish. Careless thoughts that we perish. Thus then Jesus said to them, so you men of little faith. Why did he refer to them as men of little faith? Was he expecting them to do some miracles and stop the storm? Was he expecting them to maybe do something strange? No. He was expecting them to sleep with him in the storm. What God is saying is this: I can't be with you in the storm, and the storm will take your life. The Prince of Peace will not be with you in the storm, and you will not have peace in your storm. It's not possible. For as Jesus is in that situation with you, you are coming out strong. For though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, because thou art with me. I have you with me. I have no reason to fear. Sometimes I'm not conscious about God being with me in my trouble, and Him bringing me out of the trouble. Because for Him to be with me in the trouble, it means that nothing can happen to me. It's a sign to those who were waiting for my fall for them to see how the Lord have kept me. But God is saying something to you today, and that word is this: what if nothing shows up in you? What if the situation was just silent and God allows you to come? You find somebody like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in a situation where they were faced with a challenge of bowing down to the God of Nebuchadnezzar. And just then, these guys are standing their ground. They told Nebuchadnezzar, whether our God saves us or not, let it be written that we will not bow down to this God. Let it be written. Let this be habit. Record breakers are not those who are still after what God will give them. Record breakers are those who are going after what they will give to God. What they can do in this kingdom of God. Let it be known to you, whether you like it or yes, that we are not going to give into that thing. Let me come and say, okay, as you want to challenge me, let me show you that I have power to do everything. He sent some men there to steer up the fire. To steer up the fire. The men that went to steer up the fire died in the fire. And they took Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and they threw them in the fire. But just step right away in the fire. The Nebuchadnezzar was looking. And then for 3 people, they turned to 4. The 4th person was with them. And then Nebuchadnezzar asked, he said, did we not kill 3 men inside there? How is it that we have seen 4? And the 4th one looked like the Son of God. Sometimes you won't see the reality of God until you have found your period of tests. It's in the middle of your testing period that the presence of God will be so evident in your life. Jesus never appeared when they refused to bow down. No, it was in the fire that they saw His identity. I don't know what I'm speaking to here. I don't know what is coming out of you like this in the form of this fire right now. But God is saying, I am appearing in your fire. And because I am appearing in your fire will not be able to hurt you. That fire will not hurt you. That hunger will not take your life. That poverty will not take your life. will uphold you, will grant you grace beyond your expectations. Where others go and fail, you will go there and succeed. In the midst of your competitors, the Lord will lift up your head. You will see the glory of the Lord in the land of the living. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit.
Sundays, stay tuned, and I pray the Lord shall reach you at the point of